Yep, you read that correct. I bought Matic under a cent and this project gives me similar vibes, but it's actually even better. And you probably would have never guessed who's behind the project, so make sure you stick around to find out. So let's get started. Just a quick disclaimer, none of the things mentioned in this video is financial advice and or should be taken as a financial advice. Always do your own research before investing in any of the projects mentioned in these videos, and I will not be liable for any financial or any other damages that you've done on your end by following the information in this video. This video is only for educational purposes and entertainment purposes and nothing else. Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is me, host Projwell. Keeping the state of the market aside, I hope you guys have an awesome start of the year. I've talked about Metis a couple of times on Twitter, so if you got onto it then, congratulations. And if you're not following me on Twitter, it's One Life Investment. In this video, I present to you my bullish case for Metis and why I believe it's superior to Optimism, Arbitrum, or any other layer 2 that we currently have for Ethereum at the moment. Metis is currently trading at $200 of the time me making this video, and if we compare that to its big brother in the ETH layer space, that is Matic, it should be at least $7,499 or $7,500. Given the market cap should be around 16 billion. The circulating supply and the total supply also comes into play, which I'll go into a bit detail later, but this is just for a perspective on how big Metis can be. The tech is completely different, I understand, between Metis and Matic, but they are playing on the same field, which is making ETH blockchain more scalable, faster, and accessible. Now let's get a better understanding of the project, but as always, I'll keep it simple and not get too technical. Let's start with what is Metis. Metis is a fork of Optimism with few improvements, thus it's an EVM compatible ETH layer 2 scaling solution that uses the optimistic rollup technology. This allows for super fast transaction speeds, and I mean super fast. I've never seen anything faster than Metis, all for a low gas fees. The gas fees are currently a bit higher, up to $3 sometimes, but that will go down and will be in cents soon this quarter or end of this month, but I'll explain later how they're planning to do that and why that probably will happen soon. It was originally founded in 2019, so you can imagine all the work that has gone into developing the tech and the product. Two things I always look for before investing is the problem they're solving, the use case of the project or the token or the tech itself. And the second is the team. If they are doxed, and look at the background, look at where they come from, look at their past experience and see, because if you have a solid team behind a project, it's inevitable that you will get good returns on your investment further down the road. And also, I'm preparing other tutorials and guides dedicated to navigate the Metis ecosystem and use the dApps, bridges, and other protocols on this promising layer 2 for Ethereum. So watch out on the description or on the cards in the top right corner for other guides related to Metis, which will be updated once they are up. Let's look at the Metis team. So we have Alina Sinelnikova, co-founder and CEO, Kevin Liu and Yuan Su, co-founders and product lead and the tech lead as well. All of them are pioneers in what they've done, and their past records indicate exactly that. Alina is an angel investor and is also the co-founder of Crypto Chicks, which is a reputable non-profit organization that is helping in educating and promoting women in the blockchain field. And she's also regarded as one of Canada's top women in blockchain. Kevin and Yuan both have sound experience in software development, management, and much more during the long years spent at IBM by going through the LinkedIn profiles. If you'd like to check out the profile yourself, the links will be in the description below, along with all the other links for the resources and websites mentioned in this video. And yes, Natalia Emeline, mother of Ethereum creator Vitalik Buterin, is also on board and is the ecosystem DAC manager for Metis. Natalia and Elena both co-founded CryptoChicks, sharing the same goal and vision. A lot of things that Metis is building aligns with Vitalik's vision for Ethereum and the future of the blockchain in general. For example, the idea of DSCs, decentralized autonomous corporations, the idea which was brought up by Vitalik back in 2014, super fast transaction speeds while staying true to the layer 1 and not interfering with the base layer security, and much more. And I know it's all speculation, but there must be some exchanges of ideas and vision between Vitalik and his mother, right? And if you use Metis, you will see why I'm so bullish on Metis. Now let's look at the tokenomics a little bit of the project. Tokenomics is also kind of bullish. You can see the distribution, the founding team is 7%, advisor 1%, 5%, angel investors 1%. The main thing is the remaining 47.7% will be minted over 10 years following Metis mainnet launch. Looking at the release schedule, the next release is on 13th of Jan. So depending on when this video is out, this is probably already released. There's 22,500 being released for community star investors and 11,250 for strategic investors. So this might be a good time if the token dumps a little bit to pick some Metis if you like. Now, without beating around the bush and wasting your time, I present to you my bullish case for Metis. The first thing is the fund. METISDAO has a 100 million fund called Genesee, and its main goal is to support projects which join the ecosystem. So this will attract a lot of devs and projects wanting to build on Metis, which brings me to my next point. It pays the dev for building on Metis. Metis has a builder mining program. Since all the transaction fees are paid in the Metis token on the Metis layer 2 ecosystem, 30% from the overall gas fees collected will be distributed among the developers or the ecosystem projects depending on the amount of transactions or volume the project has done. Metis is more decentralized than other optimistic rollups. And why I say that is if you look at the chart, you can see Arbitrum and Optimism have single party sequencers and validators as compared to a random sequencer and a multi-party fraud detection system on Metis. So what you need to understand is, if you know about the Arbitrum failure a couple of days ago because the sequencer went down because they use single party sequencer, Metis should not face that in the future. But you never know, once the ecosystem is used on a higher scale and once it faces a huge volume, that's when you get to see the issues. For example, Solana blockchain has gone down many times in the past, and this wasn't the case. No one talked about this before actually the blockchain was starting or blockchain was being used for different projects. So we'll still have to see, but the project, the way they've built Metis is to make them resilient to these kinds of issues, right? And another thing is Metis has a dedicated storage. So if you're not familiar with the term IPFS, it stands for Interplanetary File System. It basically is Web3 version of cloud storage. It's basically Amazon Web Services or Amazon Cloud Storage, but decentralized. So it's completely decentralized file storage system. What this basically does is, instead of storing the data on the chain, which makes the blockchain clunky as the data is not always used or is used for the current transaction, also stored on chain. All the data on the chain are stored off chain, and only the CID, which stands for the content identifier, is stored on the chain. All the CID are unique and represent a unique set of data on the IPFS. So if some data related to a CID is required, only that data is called, making the transaction lightweight and reducing the stress that is put on the blockchain. So you can compare this to similar if you have done web designing. Instead of putting everything on the same page, it calls whatever is required as the user desires. For example, that makes the web page very light, right? And loads faster. So it's a similar idea, if you would like to, if I can put it in simpler terms. Metis will implement this in Q1 or probably in few months or coming months. And then the transaction cost should drop to a few cents as compared to a dollar or three at the moment. Another thing, so easy Web2 to Web3. So I know Web3 is a buzzword these days and it's randomly thrown around, but Metis does truly believe and contributes towards the Web3 future of the web. It makes it super easy for normal Web2 companies to move to Web3 and create DSC, DAX, decentralized autonomous companies or corporations, or Metis with this easy to use tools, and eliminates the bottleneck of a slow, clunky and expensive layer 1, regardless that is ETH, which is very slow, or it is Solana, Avalanche, or other layer ones. So you have to understand the other layer ones have not been battle tested as much as ETH has. The only problem ETH has at the moment is the bottleneck, and it's slow and it's expensive. And once those things are solved, and Metis does solve it, but once it's solved on layer one as well, we should see the narrative change, because Ethereum has never failed. The network has never gone down. There was a hack on the initial days, but after that, we have never seen any issues on ETH layer one. Another one for sure is Vitalik's mom. I know. Yep. Regardless of what others say, I think this is very bullish for Metis to have Vitalik's family member on the board, and especially because he is the manager of the DSCs, DAX on Metis. And since there's a lot of things that Metis has followed and looks like has been following along with Vitalik's imagination of the blockchain future, it makes sense that we will see Metis right along that path, right? There's so many other things that I can talk about. There's so many other things that are related to Metis, and I do want you to go and check it out and do your own research as well. This has gone up a lot and in the past days and weeks. Like I said, I never give out financial advice, and you should never take anything from this videos as a financial advice. So do your own research before you decide to invest accordingly. One thing to look at is if you go to L2 Beat and it shows you the TVL. I know a lot of people don't care about TVL and think this is not a good metrics, which is okay. That is fine, but it does give you a signal that okay, this a layer 2 solution is actually getting a lot of attention. And if you go and have a look, Metis was down here until last week, right? And it's moved up to number 5, and 7-day change, as you can see, 29%. So what happens usually is, now Metis has a lot of farming like NetSwap, Tethers, and there's a lot of other DEXs on it that is getting a lot of attention. So people move to new projects or a new ecosystem. That makes sense. Like, so if I was an optimism and if I saw Metis and if there's farming opportunities on Metis to make some extra money during these times, people move their funds. So that makes sense. But that does not take away the fact that this is getting attention. And once you use Metis, you can sense and you can feel what the project will bring in the future. So that's one thing to look at, right? So that's, and if you look at DeFi Llama, as you can, number 4 is Metis, 7-day change is 84%. But you can see there's only 3 protocols on it. There's a lot of other coins and other projects that people have started, since it's very easy to deploy protocols and coins on it. So if you are using Metis, if you don't jump on every project that you see, make sure you understand if the project is legit or if it's actually been acknowledged by the Metis team itself. But as you can see, there's only 3 protocols on Metis at the moment. So you can imagine once we have a different other protocols, for example, at least half of the Phantom, or we have 136 protocols on Avalanche, 166 protocols on Matic, and everyone is rushing to launch on Metis. As you know, if you have used Polygon for a long time, or if you are a regular user of Polygon, you would understand that Polygon is not exactly as good as you think it is, right? So I've struggled with Polygon before, where I would send a transaction, it will take half an hour for the transaction to go through. And recently there's a really popular game, I'm not sure what the game is, but there's a game that is clogging up the Matic network, Polygon network, and Polygon is not as decentralized as Metis as well. So I know the end users don't care about decentralization, but if a project is decentralized, it comes with a lot of benefits, as you see with the Arbitrum going down, and it's very centralized as compared to Metis. And since Metis has its own dedicated storage, that gives it another advantage as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if Polygon and Metis become two of the competitive layer 2 solutions for Ethereum, and unless Arbitrum and Optimism, they come out of the token, and then things might change. As you know, Arbitrum has 51 protocols on it with 1.8 billion locked up, and Metis has 3 protocols on it with 201 million locked up. And one of the really good things about Metis that I'm seeing a trend is a lot of projects decide to do a fair launch on Metis, or it will be a liquidity mining launch sort of thing. So that's really good. So everyone can take part in it. At the moment, there's NetSwap and there's also Tethys, 2 of them, which are getting a lot of traction, and there's other ones as well. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified when those videos are up on Metis. So yeah, I'm very bullish on Metis. I do hold some Metis, so please make sure you understand that this is not me shilling my bags, but this is just for educational purposes. And like I said, this is not a financial advice. Please let me know what are your thoughts on Metis, if you've been in Metis for a long time, or if you have any other projects in your horizon that is looking good and that might be as promising as this. I'll make sure that I check it out and make a video if possible. If you made it to the end of this video, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up, as that helps out a lot, and comment if you have any questions, any queries, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you, and you have a nice day.